Mini Beam Steam Model M88 by Microcosm. You have the alcohol burner down here. This is the boiler. It's a walking beam. Steam drives the power piston upwards. Then this sliding valve arrangement comes to this position, opens the vent, and momentum on the flywheel pushes the piston back down this exhaust. The valve goes back to the closed position, opens steam up to the bottom of the piston, and it goes up again. And on the other side, there's a safety valve. And if that goes off, that sounds a little bit like a tea kettle or a pressure cooker. There's a little silicone O-ring here that seals when it's down. And on the inside, that's spring loaded. When pressure builds up, it lifts up on this piston, which is spring loaded. That will release any excess pressure. And then there's an O-ring here that seals against the boiler. You just close it against that O-ring, then give it just a little more. That's good enough. If you know this boiler is empty, then you can unscrew this pressure relief valve, and you can add 20 milliliters of water with a syringe or a small funnel. Put this back in. When you tighten this down, it just needs to be firm. You don't have to tighten the heck out of it. And you should check to make sure this is free to operate. 20 milliliters of water will take you to about here. You do not want to fill this any more than 2/3 full. And if you start boiling it too violently, then the water can slosh up and you'll get water in here instead of steam. And that may stop the engine. This one has three rods that sit down in pockets in the alcohol burner. And they index into these holes, which is the lid of the boiler. If you know the alcohol burner is empty, you can use a syringe, put 12 milliliters of alcohol in through the vent hole. Easiest way to tell if it's empty is if the wick is dry. If the wick is wet, then you want to be careful. You do not want to overfill this. One thing that happens with every one of these burners, the heat from the fire reflects off of the boiler, comes down and heats this up. And the hotter this gets, the bigger the fire gets. So you do not want to overfill this. You only want to fill this about 2/3 full, max. You want to put oil on all of these pivot points. And I put a little bit on the power piston and on the valve. Anything that wiggles or turns, there's a stationary pivot here. And then on the axle for the flywheel and the counterbalance, I put a little bit of oil here and here and turn it. And do that before every run. Oil's cheap. You oil this before every run, and don't run this thing too fast. This thing will last you a long time. This is a very well-made little model. And when you start this, this runs counterclockwise, viewed from this side. It's a very nice little engine, very delicate parts. You want to treat this gently. This is really not a kid's play toy. If you drop this on a hard surface or on a concrete, that'll be the end of this. You'll bend and break this. It won't run anymore. But as received, this is very smooth and the timing is exact. But when this thing gets up to speed, it'll start throwing oil out too. So I have it on this piece of cardboard. To start off with a reasonable size fire, if this gets too hot, I take something like this dental tool and I push that wick back down a little bit. If it looks like it's getting to be a bit weak, I'll reach in here with a pair of pliers and just pull that up a little bit. That's a pretty large fire. That'll be too big for the engine, but it will leave it like that until it builds up pressure. I check this with an infrared thermometer. Just kind of get an idea how fast that temperature is coming up. As the pressure builds up, you may start to see bubbles on the power piston or on the sliding valve. There we go. And that fire is too big, so I'm going to reduce its size a little bit. This is a good speed for this. If this starts screaming and the pop-off valve is whistling, your fire's too big. You're running it too fast. Slow it down. This is actually running a little bit faster than what I would care for. So I'll move that fire down just a little bit. I reduced that fire, so I haven't heard that pop-off valve go off. So that's a good thing. Operate this at a sensible speed, and it will last a long time. Do not walk off and leave this unattended or around children unattended. This gets extremely hot. This ran for just over 20 minutes. That's a long run. Now just leave it alone and let it cool off naturally.